Part 2, wiring up the Alpine overhead. We've gone over how to mount the overhead, trim the bezel so that it goes up against the headliner properly. Now we've extended our little short harness that they give you. Why they do that. Come on, give us a full length wire. So green is our door, ground is black is ground, red is an accessory. This, going to the paint, because that's what I've got the most of right now, go figure, is for the antenna, the FM broadcast antenna that's inside the overhead monitor. And then our battery. Accessory, ground, door. So, heat shrink it up, put it in the vehicle. Harness all put together. Wire is extended. Use a nylon expandable flex. I like it better than loom. Looks better. Protects a little better too in most cases. Run it down about 6 foot of it on there. So that just protects it in the roof. Power wire, dome light trigger, antenna run. A couple of things to point out when you're doing something like this. If you have a sunroof, make sure when you're running the wires that you don't get caught up in the track of the sunroof. Luckily, we do not have a sunroof here. Number two, when running wires around an airbag, make sure you go over top of the airbag, in between the airbag and the body. Do not go between the airbag and a panel or a headliner. You do not want to risk, on deployment, cutting the airbag in two. People frown on that. Going down to the interior of the vehicle, and on a Toyota Sienna 2014, you can actually find your dome light trigger, which is your negative door. So, damn it. Out of there. Light green wire. Zoom in. Light green wire on the 18 pin. Wire's pulled from corner of the dash. They go along the top of the dash, well, under the dash, above the cluster. Soldered into the radio harness. Live, so be careful. Light blue is your hot battery. Gray is your ignition. Brown is your ground. Light blue. And just because I'm anal, a D-pin and heat shrink. Make sure you use a 3-to-1 heat shrink because you've got to get an 1/8 inch or larger over top of some of these connectors, especially in ignition harnesses. So, it just holds a lot better, and that's 3-to-1 with adhesive in it, too. Pink wire that runs from the FM antenna, coming from the DVD monitor. I just kind of slip it in. It's got a sleeve over it, but I try to get it as close to the radio as possible. The little shorty antenna that they supply with, it just isn't enough. I kind of ran across this trick by accident. I was like, you know, screw it, I'll just run an antenna down and maybe tap the antenna, but it works without tapping. It improves the reception by 1,000 times. So you tie your wires up, make sure everything's out of the way. These Toyotas, it's pretty roomy back there. Tip on getting these Sienna dash, the heater controls out of a Sienna dash. And the clips all the way in, take a screwdriver, small screwdriver, pry up. I can't do it one-handed. Pry up. Then pull out, because you'll destroy or lose that clip because it comes off. Leave it to Alpine to have the worst FM broadcast. So we're going to go aux in on the deck. So pop out your switch, sorry, your plug, USB aux. You disassemble the little jewel. Then you attach your left positive Ride positive. Your shield for both. You get some RCA females. Now these two have to be bridged because there's a 2.7K resistor online. When you plug it in, it shorts these out. So if you don't short those out or put a 2.7 across those wires, it won't go to auxiliary.